In this video, we'll explain the basic usage of the Rapier 3D for WithThreeJS extension. The Rapier 3D for WithThreeJS extension allows you to use the Rapier 3D physics engine inside WithThreeJS. GDevelop includes the Jolt 3D physics engine, but it cannot be used with WithThreeJS. Instead, please use this extension. Please note that this extension is still a beta version with limited functionality. Therefore, the way it is used may change in future updates. You can download the Rapier 3D for WithThreeJS, also known as R4W3JS, from the WithThreeJS page. After downloading, import the files with 3js.json and R4W3JS.json into your game. First, create a 3D scene with WithThreeJS. Please wait for a moment. Now that the scene is ready, use the Start Rapier 3D Physics Engine action to start the 3D Physics Engine. In this action, you can set gravity and enable the debug visualization. Please note that this action is asynchronous. For more information about asynchronous actions, please check the GDevelop documentation. Next, set the ground as a static rigid body. Use the Add Rigid Body action to add a rigid body to the ground. In this action, you can set parameters such as the body type, shape, size, and weight. The shape is defined around the origin of the 3D object. If the origin is not at the center, you can adjust it using the offset parameters. Next, let's set the box as a dynamic rigid body. Let's preview the scene. We can confirm that the 3D physics engine is working correctly. Since the debug feature is enabled, we can see and check the shapes of the rigid bodies. Let's add more boxes. When there are multiple objects, you need to use a for each object event. Let's preview it and confirm that everything is working correctly. So, how can we dynamically add more boxes with rigid bodies? First, let's add an event so that an object is created when we click. Then, let's make sure the add rigid body action runs right after that. When we click, the object is created, but the rigid body in the 3D physics engine behaves strangely. The reason is that the 3D object doesn't actually exist yet when we try to add the rigid body. The WithThreeJS behavior attached to a 2D object generates the actual 3D object in the next frame, after the 2D object has been created. So, we'll use a variable to find 3D objects that don't yet have a rigid body, and add it at the right time. After adding a rigid body, set the variable of that object to true. Don't forget to apply the same logic to the boxes that already exist at the start of the scene. Now everything works correctly. Next, let's see how to add a rigid body to a 3D object that was created using a With3JS action. Now that the 3D model object has been added, the Enable With3JS object is no longer needed, so let's delete it. Let's make it so that a human is created when you right-click. When you create a 3D object directly using a With3JS action, the 3D object is generated immediately. This means you can run the Add Rigid Body action right after it. we can see that a spherical rigid body has been added at the origin of the human object. Let's adjust the offset parameters so that the rigid body is added at the center of the human object. We can see that the rigid body has been added at the center of the human object. Let's try some other shapes as well. We can see that a box-shaped rigid body has been added. However, I notice a problem here. Only the first human has had a rigid body added multiple times. The cause is simple. I didn't assign a unique ID to each 3D object. In many cases, a counter is used to give numbered IDs, but here I'll use a simpler method by adding the current time to the ID. We can confirm that everything is now working correctly. Let's continue and try some other shapes as well. It's possible to lock the translation or rotation of a rigid body. Let's try locking the rotation of the capsule. Finally, let's try a convex shape. This extension has a built-in feature that automatically generates a convex shape for the 3D object. So, there's no need to specify the size. Adjust the offset if necessary. That's all for this basic tutorial. Please note that this extension is still in beta, so its usage may change in the future. It will continue to be updated, so please look forward to future improvements.